You thought that you was doing this on your own, and you thought that you was being kind, and you thought that because we set this day aside for our choir anniversary that you had to come to church this morning. But that wasn't your decision.
Mm-hmm.
Decision was already made
for
you a long time ago. See, your problem is you're trying to make a decision, but don't you know any time that you make a decision, God can change your plan.
That's right.
Yeah, he's the God that changes people's plans. I heard it in a song one time that if a man can plan, but God can change. I don't care how you plan a thing, if God have a plan for you to be in a certain place at a certain time, there's no way that you can get around it. Well, I can prove it to you. Then since Jonah tried to run from God, he ended up getting in a village, in the middle of a village. But you see, when he got so low in his life, that the Bible said that the well filled him up, and he had to make a 3 days journey. And that's something how we can get in trouble, but you still end up at the appointed time that God wanted you to be there in the first place. I'm just saying, because sometimes we think that it's all about us.
That's right.
And we think that this is our time. But there was nothing you could have done to get away from this morning. Well, here in our lesson, we find that a man has been sick, and he has gone to this pool for 38 long years. The Bible said he was an impotent man, and there were impotent folks, and there was blind folks, and some that was withered up, but they was at the pool for the time of the troubling of the water. And I want to share with you this morning the name of the pool was called Bethesda, which means is the house of mercy, or the house of grace. Isn't it amazing that you can see people come to church Sunday after service, Sunday, and it's still like they don't get any better?
Come on.
I wonder this morning, do you know anybody that has been coming for the church for a long time and still haven't gotten any better?
Come on, preach up.
Attitude is still all jacked up. They still treat you for a long time. But they say that they love the Lord. Something is wrong with that, because you've been coming just a little too long. But I'm gonna tell you now, keep on coming, baby.
That's right.
It's going to happen into your life. And I had a problem with this man, and I had a problem with his friends, because I felt like that his friends could have helped him in a way. If they knew that he had been coming for 38 years, it seemed like to me that somebody would have pushed him on into what a
good.
But you know, when you're in a bad situation, your friends sometimes don't want you to get out of that situation. It seemed, and I had a problem with the people that brought him there, because you could have easily picked him up and before anybody got and threw him in the water.
That's right.
If you want to see me here, do what you must do. But we do know that there was three friends that cut the roof off a house.
That's right.
To get to Jesus, you got to do what you have to do.
Right.
But it bothered me about the friends. It didn't mention friends, but it bothered me about the friends. He had to get there somehow. So it had to be somebody to bring him there, being that he wasn't able to walk. And then it bothered me also about him, because the Bible said he just made it. Now, he said when he was coming down, he was an impotent man. That means that he couldn't walk. He didn't have the strength enough to walk. Why didn't he just roll down? when you want your healing, when you want your deliverance, you would do anything necessary to get to your healing, but he just left it.
Amen.
And I got upset with him, and I got upset with his friend, but then the Lord brought it back to my attention that it was not his time.
Yet. It wasn't his time.
Right.
You see, we can be in line, but it may not be our time.
Amen.
And for 38 years, he laid there, and
yes,
every time he was waiting for something to happen. And I come to tell you that If you come to church waiting for something,
come on, preach up.
It may not happen the way you think it's going to happen.
Yeah.
You may not get the goosebumps and the crying and all that. It may not come that way. It may just come through a word.
Yes.
Amen.
To let you know that, that something is going to happen.
Amen.
And I believe this morning that if you stay with me long enough,
yeah.
If you sit there long enough and when you start feeling the Spirit, something will happen.
Yeah,
and I believe it. I wish I had my drum over there on the drum. Right. On the washing on the drum. Just get over there.
Amen.
I'm going to do something. And I need my drum. I need my drum. And Sam will do it the way it was shown to me.
Praise God.
And this is what I want you to do. Give me a little drum roll.
Amen.
It don't have to be loud, but just a little drum roll.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
I want you to just give me a drum roll, and that's going to be the sign of a stirring of a war. Every time. Listen.
Thank you, Lord.
We're getting ready.
Uh-huh.
To get something started in here.
Come on, good job.
Because we have been sitting around too long,
yeah,
waiting on something to happen.
Yeah.
Now, I don't care how long you sit there, how long you've been in that condition that you say that you're in,
uh-huh,
God has a way of bringing you out.
That's right.
For 38 long years, here this man in a bad condition.
Uh-huh.
He came to the house of mercy.
Yes, he did.
And it seems like to me, when you come to the house of mercy, there should be some power in the house of mercy.
Yeah. Yeah.
But because his friends and because he didn't want to do anything about his condition, he just laid there.
Uh-huh.
Year after year, he's laying there waiting on the movement of. But every time he got ready to step in the water,
come on,
somebody stepped in.
That's all right.
Year after year, in the same shape, coming to church year after year.
Amen.
For you.
That's right,
have
Pastor.
Have you ever been in a situation
and
you come through a next in line?
Preach, sir.
And when you got ready to step in, somebody stepped in.
Yeah. That's all right, Pastor.
Preach. Yeah.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Come on.
This morning.
My God.
That there will be a troubling of the water.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Y'all waiting on something to happen.
Go ahead, come on, preach up.
And it's already happening.
Thank you, God.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, God.
And the Bible says that the first one that stepped in.
Yes. That's all right now, Pastor.
Ooh, God.
That's right.
The first one to step in.
Yes, God.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, I'm waiting for something to happen. Because ain't nobody moved yet.
Yeah. Come on, preach up.
Although this here is not a physical move.
Yes, God.
This here is a natural move.
That's all right, Pastor.
My God.
Nobody has moved yet.
It's all right, Pastor.
And the only person that has moved is the one that's filming me.
That's all right.
That's all right, Pastor.
If you want your help.
Yeah.
Oh, if you want your help.
Yeah.
Amen. It's all right.
I've got too many people in this church.
Yes, sir.
that's sick.
Yes, sir.
We fast about it.
Yes, sir.
And we pray about it.
Yes.
The trouble of the world is coming.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The trouble.
Yes, sir.
That's all right. That's all right.
I don't have to say too much no more.
Yes!
All that you have been through in your life.
Yes!
All you gotta do is just step in.
Step in!
Oh my God! Okay.
Yes!
Breathe, Pastor!
That's all right! That's all right, Pastor!
Yes, sir!
Thank you, Pastor!
Thank you, Jesus!
This is what God showed me. This is what He showed me. It wasn't His time 38 years ago.
Hallelujah!
But now it was His time.
Thank you. Hallelujah!
And because Jesus
Hallelujah.
Has came on the scene.
Yes!
He don't need the troubling of the water no more.
Yes!
He don't need
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
He don't need the troubling of the water no more. Because Jesus
Hallelujah!
Yes!
Jesus
Yes!
The deliverer.
Yes! Yes!
Don't need you.
That's all right, Pastor.
Don't need the water no more. Only thing we can do with the water now is go down.
Yes!
Yes. Come up.
Yes,
sir. That's all. I'm finished, y'all.
Yes, sir.
I'm finished. Bring it up, man. This afternoon, Sister Lisa's gonna sing that song.
Yes.
Whatever you need.
Yes.
God,
that's right.
Whatever you need right now, God's got. He's in the house. His spirit is moving. Whatever you need, whatever you desire, Lord, right now, it's in the house. You think this is for sure. But this is the way God showed it to
you. That's all right, Pastor.
He said there has to be a trouble. And I know you're tired of going through all the troubles. I know you're tired of going from hand to hand. But God said, He's here now. You don't have to worry about the water. He told the man.
Hallelujah.
He said, will you be made?
Thank you, God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
The man said, sir.
Hallelujah.
Before I can get to the
point, Hallelujah.
Somebody else.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Don't worry about the water.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said, rise up.
Yes.
Take up your bed.
Yes.
I got some people here on pain and crutches.
Yes.
They're coming home, got bad feet. Yes. Now I need somebody to don't mind giving God a praise.
Hallelujah.
Let God know that He's worthy this morning.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Speak a word.
Speak a word.
Jesus told the man to rise up.
Thank you, God.
Take up thy bed.
Thank you, God.
The problem is, we've been lying around too long.
Thank you, God.
And the water has been troubled. But you didn't step in at your time.
Thank you, God.
But now Jesus is on the scene.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to wait for the trouble.
Yes.
You don't have to wait till you get to church no more.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
You don't have to wait for a certain sin or
yes,
a certain feeling to come over you. But all you got to do is ask Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Is this all right this morning?
That's all right, Pastor.
Now we're going to have the church this afternoon.
Thank you, God.
The water.
It's trouble. Amen.
Thank you, God.
You believe that you can get delivered?
Yes.
You
believe
that somebody is going to testify?
Thank you, God.
Yes.
Thank you, God.
That's all right.
Amen.
Remember when?
It's all right.
Thank you, God.
The reverend went when he was sick.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
3 weeks ago, I was sick.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
I didn't even know the temperature in my own house.
Thank you, God.
My daughter had to come by there and say, Daddy, it's hot in here.
Thank you, God.
I was sick sweating.
Thank you, God.
I sweat out
God.
7.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
Trying to get myself together.
Come on, preach up.
Preach up.
Somebody else to come by my house.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, God.
To tell me how hot it was in my house.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, God.
And when they told me I had to do something about it, if I wouldn't have sat there for another week or so.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But because somebody passed by my house.
Yes. Thank you, God.
And I come to tell you, somebody's coming right here at your house. You waiting on such a great move, and the move has already been made.
Yes, sir.
All you got to do is begin to step out by faith.
Yes.
Amen.
The Bible doesn't speak
by faith.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You don't even speak by faith.
Come on, preach up. Preach up.
The Bible doesn't speak by faith. Jesus tells the man to rise up and walk.
Preach.
And the Bible don't say nothing about his faith, but he trusted God enough.
Amen.
Thank you, God.
He had to be in that situation. The Bible says he took up his faith.
Yes. Thank you, God.
And he began to walk.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
I must tell you, when you take up your bed,
thank you, God.
You're going to have some people to criticize you.
Thank you, God.
Because you stepped out of faith and you believed God.
Thank you, God.
Impossible.
Thank you, God.
And God.
Thank you, God.
Told me.
Thank you, God.
By faith.
Thank you, God.
We are in this thing.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God. That's right.
But there was nobody in the house
to
see me when I fell.
Yeah.
But when I got up, this is the blessing. When I got up from falling, I got up and I moved my leg.
Thank you, God. Thank you,
my God. Sometimes you start moving around just to make sure that I was all right.
Thank you, God.
Ever since that day,
thank you, God.
I've had a little pain.
Thank you, God.
I've had before. All because of the fall.
Thank you, God.
All falls are not bad.
That's right. That's right.
Some falls are for your benefit.
Thank you, God.
Trust me, sometimes you can fall and you think that that's the worst thing that ever happened.
Thank you, God.
God turned my fall around.
Hallelujah.
To my benefit.
Thank you, God.
I didn't even strain out my leg.
Thank you, God.
Didn't even bend.
Thank you, Lord.
But, my fall fixed foot. I come to tell you this morning. Your fall will fix some things in your life. Your fall will. It gets you to the point that you got to depend on God.
Thank you, God.
Just to fall.
Thank you, God.
Y'all not understanding what
thank
I
you, God.
Fell.
Thank you, God.
When you get to the loss of your love, I amen. Fell.
Yes. Amen.
Like that woman
thank you, God.
On the commercial. I've fallen and I couldn't get up.
Get up. Mm-hmm.
I just didn't know when I got up. God had already
fixed
it. And it's the guess I'm trying to tell you. That if you get up, if you rise up like the man, God has already fixed your situation.
Yeah.
But because you want to sit there and have a pity party on your own life, God can fix it. But if you get up, have you ever fallen and fixed a problem?
Thank you,
God. My God. A problem got fixed through a fall.
Thank you,
just that's what God did for me.
Yes,
through my fall, I can bend my leg.
Mm-hmm.
I can straighten my leg all the way out.
Yeah.
Through a fall.
Amen.
Is that not amazing?
That's all right.
God took something that should have been negative.
Yes.
Woo. God took a negative situation.
Yeah.
I could have broken my hip.
Because
I got caught with clothes. And I think it's sleeping under there. So it wasn't going to be no easy fall. But he turned a bad situation into a positive situation. When I failed, I got better.
Yeah.
Oh, thank God. Most people, when they fall, they get worse. But if you put your hand in God's hand, you may fall. God knows you'll get better. I never seen it. I almost said I never seen the righteous before.
Hallelujah!
When you line up with God,
thank you, God.
If you fall, he'll make that thing better.
Yes,
it will now.
Thank you, God.
Yes, it will.
Thank you, God.
Now the water has been drunk.
Thank you, God.
Jesus has been here.
Thank you, God.
Woo. I can tell you right now.
Thank you, God.
I can see it on somebody's face.
Thank you, God.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, God.
I'm going to mess with this just a little bit more.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God. Somebody's being stirred up right now.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Somebody's being stirred up.
Thank you, God.
Give me a little bit more.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
God is waiting on
you. Thank you, Lord.
You don't get this feeling too often. You don't get it too often.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
The Bible says, the day that you hear his voice, harden not your heart.
Thank you, God. Yes! Hallelujah!
I want to say so.
Yes! Hallelujah!
The Bible says he was high.
Yes! Yes. Hallelujah!
The Bible says his strength.
Yes!
It feels good.
Hallelujah!
And what I love about him is when he touched Isaiah, his coat, he cleaned it from the inside out. But Isaiah saw something.
Right. That's right.
This here is a hospital.
Yes. 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 Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Some folks don't want everybody in the church.
Come on, Pastor.
The hospital. Where can I go?
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord.
What I love about this, he didn't say because you was a lame man that I can't touch you. When he saw the lepers, he didn't tell him because he was a leper. He didn't touch him. But we don't want to touch nobody.
Come on, Pastor.
I'm finished.
Come on, Pastor.
Amen. Because when it comes to things that we don't like,
come on, Pastor. Amen.
and we know that it's against God.
Mm-hmm.
We said big time judgment.
Yes. Come on, Pastor.
Yes.
Come on, Pastor.
And God told us from the beginning to love everybody.
Yes.
With love and kindness.
Yes.
Have I grown thee?
Yes.
And the Spirit of God,
yes,
will do the work.
Yes.
If His Spirit wants it, mine show the power.
Come on, Pastor.
What Paul asked the Jews? He asked the Jews, why are you boasting? The Jews thought they had something big because it was God's chosen people. But he told them, he said, no, that's not the case. He said, you were a sinner too. You were born in sin, shaped in iniquity. So were you, and so are the Gentiles. So you have no room to boast. Simple as that.
That's right.
He teaches us to love.
Yes.
Love. Yes. It's not by chance.
Yes.
That you're here this morning.
Yes.
Amen.
It's not by chance.
Yes.
That's the thing.
Thank you.